Our next speaker is Vladimir Vysotsky. He got his doctorate from Kiev Institute in Theoretical Physics in 1975. He's now the director of the theoretical radio physics department at Kiev National Shevchenko University.
Yes, correct. Thank you.
Dear colleagues, my report, the history of this report is connected with the suggestion of the Peter. Peter asked me to give the report on this item because it's very close to the result of that Peter was presented before. So, this is the general title, yes. This short prehistory. In numerous Langer-related experiments, we observe many phenomena that are in confrontation with traditional point of physics of radiation, or physics of X-ray radiation, especially. For example, this radiation was frequently registered in absolutely abnormal system, e.g., behind the black screen. Energy was about 1.3 keV, but was registered behind the black screen with a thickness of wall about several millimeter or more. It is absolutely impossible from traditional point of view of physics of X radiation. On this figure, you can see, for example, an experiment of Violante with the same spectrum. Also, result of experiment of Storm, because very interesting, Edmund Storm, has shown that detector was situated not only other side of the wall of this installation, but many distance. But energy of registered X radiation was about only several keV. That absolutely impossible. It is an experiment of Karabuk that Peter has discussed before. Also, very interesting that in this experiment, the registered energy of X radiation was approximately the same, from 1.5 up to 1.3, for example, keV, but material of cathode was different from light material up to very heavy. It is very strange. Also, it is a view of the surface of the, for example, loading, and it is a spectral of X-ray radiation. That's what observed in experiment Karabut. A very narrow distribution. These abnormal results on X radiation in Langer-related experiment are similar to the result of our experiment on registration of X-ray radiation generated on absolutely rather different processes, on the process of an investigation of cavitation phenomena. This result will be presented in such articles, such additional articles will be discussed in the next page. Okay, let's consider our experiment. We have started our experiment about more than 10 years ago. It is an experiment where related to the analysis of problem of cavitation of different liquid stream. First series of experiment, it is an X-ray generation at bubble cavitation of machine oil. It is a scheme of installation. It is a... It is a liquid pump with machine oil. It is a cavitation chamber. It's in a diaphragm with a diameter about 1 millimeter. It's a view of this installation. In our early work, the anomalous optical phenomena accompanying the cavitation process were observed. Phenomena were observed in such chamber, cylindrical working chamber, cavitation chamber, has a length 15 centimeter, diameter about 8 centimeter, made from plexiglass, and thickness of wall was about 3 centimeter or 2 centimeter in this area. On this figure, this slide, you can see the photos of the working chamber at different regime of motion of machine oil. It is low pressure, less about 20 atmosphere. The color of pressure is natural, it is yellow, typical. The motion is from left to right. At increasing of pressure, we have the process of cavitation in the right side of this working chamber take place. At additional increase of pressure up to 60-70 atmosphere, we have the process of formation of thin stream take place, and at pressure about 90 atmosphere, we have observed the generation of bright luminescence of directed stream with cavitation bubble. It is a view of this phenomenon. It's absolutely abnormal phenomena, because in real we have a very intensive blue and white lighting of machine oil, very strange. And also inside surface we have the lighting, electrical lighting, distance about 2 centimeters, so the voltage was about 20 kV. The important question, what is the nature and the origin of this directed luminescence beam? Very different idea. First idea was it is connected with the solar luminescence. But it is not solar luminescence. There are different arguments, because very large size, and also for intensive solar luminescence need very high temperature, about 10^5 Kelvin. But in this case, the temperature was low, because it was not single bubble, but many bubble cavitation, and also intense solar luminescence decreases strongly with increased temperature, but in this case this effect was not observed. Other idea was connected, that maybe possible is connected with Cherenkov radiation, because in this system, as a result of motion of machine oil through the electric channel, the process of generation of high electricity take place, and maybe connected with with formation of a select electron. But this phenomenon, this idea is also not real, because there are different arguments. We use a ground connected to neutralize the separated volume. We measured the angular distribution of the electric beam not related to Cherenkov phenomena. We investigated the action of external transfernal magnetic field. Also, this field not influenced on the parameter of cavitation, of lighting. Next step was connected with the search of the reason of such phenomena. For such idea, we have used the X-ray radiation detector that was situated outside of this working chamber. It is X-ray radiation, the same Markham text, of course, situated, and the detector is situated near cavitation chamber in regime of cavitation, because this motion machine oil from left to right. This A part of the working chamber was natural machine oil with yellow color, and with this white color is a process of cavitation. It is before the intensive lighting. We have used, it is a calibration of X spectrometer using by Mosbauer isotope iron 57, very good resolution of the spectrometer. It's okay. In the first experiment, we have observed that outside of cavitation chamber, outside on the other side of very thick wall with thickness about 2 centimeters, we have observed the X-ray radiation. The X-ray radiation was energy changing from about 0.9 keV up to 1.34 keV, and the peak of the spikes of this radiation changing at increasing of the pressure, up to, for example, 20, 40, and 65 atmosphere, changing of in energy and the decreasing of amplitude, magnitude. Registering such soft X radiation with energy about from 1 up to 2 keV, which is connected with the cavitation phenomena inside the chamber, outside the thick wall, cavitation is on the first side very, very strange, because the absorption main free pass for such diapason is no more than 10 or 20 microns. The same paradox takes place in Lenz experiments that I have discussed before. We have studied this paradox using different methods. First method, process of simulation of generation of additional radiation. It is a cross section of cavitation chamber. We have situated on the surface of chamber, powder of Kappa, using special method for special viscosity suspense. And also what we see, without Kappa powder, the pike of radiation was about energy, about 1 keV. With additional Kappa powder, we observed changing of the energy up to 3.5 keV. When we have used the thin Kappa foil for screening, we have cut off a weak part of radiation, soft part of radiation, we have X-ray radiation with changing energy up to 3.5 keV. The result of such investigation found that the source of radiation is connected with surface of chamber. Nature or reason or source of energy, of course, is connected with the cavitation process. Cavitation process is inside the chamber, but the generation outside of chamber. For more detailed analysis of such phenomena, we have used distance-dependent analysis of the intensity of X radiation, changing the distance from the surface of cavitation chamber to windows of the detector. And we have observed that maximal intensity will be a distance about 3.5 centimeters. It is very easy to understand this phenomenon, because for changing of distance, there are two phenomena take place. From one side, from one hand, the process of absorption, space dependent. From other side, increasing of surface that generated X radiation in the direction of X-ray detector. If we have the expression for total intensity and maximal intensity of such radiation at such value, it is absorption path for calculation from some diapason, we have the same 4 centimeters, approximately the same such experiment. So the source of X radiation are situated on the surface of the cavitation chamber. It is a result of investigation of vibration state of cavitation chamber. We have using the small size acoustic detector that was situated on surface, and it is a signal from the surface, and after some separation, we have the approximately very close to the harmonic oscillation with frequency about 22 kilohertz. It is a spectrum 22 kilohertz. It is the calibration of acoustic impulses registered system, and in result, the magnitude of vibration on the surface of cavitation chamber was about from 200 up to 300 angstrom. What is the mechanism of such connection between acoustic pulse and reality? Not acoustic, usual acoustic pulse, shocking pulse, and X-ray radiation. The formation of shock wave processes based on the description of Navier-Stokes equation, this equation, equations. And it is a typical evolution of the Babel cavitation process, inertial stage. It's a micronucleus of a gas bubble with a compressed liquid. At the beginning, growth of gas in the tangent liquid, growth phase also, the phase of unstable balance and phase of bubble collapsing. So we have the very intensive bubble collapsing, very strong squeezing, and next explosion and generation of cavitation of acoustic or shocking wave. What process takes place in our chamber? More detail. There is a machine oil stream, and also on the end of the thin channel, the process of formation of cavitation bubble in time and in space take place after initial increasing, and after decreasing, the process of collapse take place. In result of collapse, the process of generation of acoustic wave near the surface take place. This acoustic wave acts on the wall, some processes is connected with the motion of such wave to the external surface, and also part of this wave traveling along the surface and act on the already soil. So we have the fact that acoustic feedbacks. In fact, it's a generator Van der Pol, well-known generator of Van der Pol, and it results lead to the such a process creation, not a stochastic process, a generation in the view of such pulses, such bunches, special bunches. It is also such a model description of such processes, the process of cavitation, formation of acoustic wave, transformation of acoustic wave, very intensive, to shocking wave, action of shocking wave of the internal surface of the wall, motion of shocking wave inside the surface, reflection of shocking wave from an external surface, and excitation of surface atom that lead to generation of Higgs radiation. Because the front of shocking wave is very large, the process of excitation of surface atom is coherent. In this case, in fact, we have the sources of X radiation with very large transversal coherency, not longitudinal, not laser coherency, but transversal coherency. And of course, it's lead to formation of directed X-ray radiation from such surface that we have observed. What is the mechanism of atom excitation by action of shock wave? It's well known from quantum mechanics, method of sudden excitation. When we have initial state, for example, in state 1s wave function, and when function is the same, but momentum after action of shock wave is different, changing because the process of motion takes place, and after it is easy to calculate the probability of excitation, for example, for such transition, it is a final expression. And also the probability, for example, for such transition is the following. And for example, in our case, we have using the kappa, z equal to 29, and then surface concentration of atom was about 10^17 per centimeter square. And result, we have the intensity of X radiation, excited atom, and X radiation, it's about 10^6 excited atom per 1 centimeter, is very similar to the intensity of X radiation that we have observed. For large surface, it's about approximately up to 100 centimeters, the intensity of X radiation of activity was about 0.01 curie. So it is an intermediate conclusion. The generation of X radiation outside of the cavitation chamber is the result of the transformation of cavitation shock wave in liquid to shock wave in the cavitation chamber wall and further excitation of atoms on the external surface of the chamber. At high liquid pressure, what is the reason of such blue color? Very interesting. At high liquid pressure, the liquid jet does not touch the internal surface of chamber wall, and the cavitation shock wave leak through reflection from the jet vacuum body of what of machine oil stream to the excitation of jet surface. It's in effect, we have observed the same phenomena that take place outside of chamber, but it's inside of chamber. X-ray, we have observed because the thickness of wall is very thickness, several centimeters, but we have blue, white blue color. Next part of my presentation, the generation of intensive X-ray radiation at a free exit of fast water jet from metal channel. Our initial experiments were connected with an analysis of cavitation machine oil, but machine oil, it is not good liquid for analysis because in the result of circulation at high pressure, the changing the chemical, physical contents, changing the temperature, so on, changing all properties take place, and it is not good for stability of in experiment. So we have conducted experiment with usual water stream without any circulation. We have used the KMT industrial equipment for cutting and driving of thick metal and ceramic plates by water jet. It is a special equipment. From this hole, the water stream with pressure from 200 up to 2,200 atmosphere generated. And we have using this equipment for conducted an additional experiment. You see the water stream, it is an X-ray generator, X-ray detector immediately situated near stream or somewhat. It is a view of the water stream at one of the regime of investigation. Very interesting that his first initial experiment, we have observed that surface of water stream, not metal cube, but surface of water stream, also is a source of X radiation. It is a spectrum of X radiation generated by free fast cavitation water at pressure 600 atmosphere. It is a spectrum of X radiation of steel surface of the rod, not far from the space where the water stream go to the free space. Of course, for the steel, of the surface of the steel, energy more, in this case about 1 keV, and there is about 1.9, maybe up to 2 keV. Also, when we have added a couple, lead powder to the surface, we have additional changing of the pike of the X radiation up to 4.5 keV. So on this figure you can see spectra of X radiation from water stream, from iron, and from copper. Different. Spectrum of X radiation depends on the kind of materials. Also, we have conducted additional experiment using not only X-ray detector, but also photoplates. We have used medical X-ray screen, different, for example, Kodak, different films, well-known photoplates. What experiment? The image of two X-ray films situated without clearance in coaxial geometry, typical tube, was put on the area where the end of the metal tube and the beginning of the water stream in this situation. And after explosion, during several minutes, I don't remember, about 10 minutes here, we have observed on both films a very black signal, X-ray signal, in the area where this film was situated near metal. And this lower part was situated where was water stream. What is the reason why this black and this white? Because in the case of metal, we have generated more X-ray radiation with more high energy, and distance from surface of tube to the such photoplate was about 1 centimeter. It's good for X-ray radiation from metal, but it's very long distance for X-ray radiation, for soft radiation from water stream. One plate is more dark and other more weak. It's okay because this plate was situated near the metal tube and this was next. So the process of screening takes place. It is very interesting phenomenon. It is absolutely abnormal effect. What is on this figure? You can see it is a pinoplast support plate, and also was tube. In this tube was situated the cavitation water jet from this direction. And also was situated metal, thick metal plate with thickness about 3 millimeter, and was distance 1 centimeter, 2 photoplates. And totally symmetrically was situated 2 photoplates. All photoplates, of course, in black envelope. And also, after some during exposition, about maybe 20 minutes, we have investigated the signal on this photoplate. From a normal point of view, of course, it is necessary signal may be on these 3 photoplates. But on the photoplate is situated outside of thick metal plate, signal may be absent. But result is absolutely opposite. This A and B photoplates is photoplates that were situated on the other side of thick metal screen. And free photoplate was absolutely without any signal. What is the reason of such very strange phenomena? It is a view of our metal screen. One side of metal screen was with old paint, and on this paint was many different defects. And other was has an atomically pure surface. And also, next is the one. What is the situation where this in this case? It is a source of cavitation. X-ray cavitation lead to the formation of weak or soft X-radiation. After absorption of that X-radiation, the process of generation additional acoustic and shocking wave take place. This shocking wave interact with surface of metal, generated additional X-ray, shocking wave, and the motion of such shocking wave through the this metal plate lead to excitation of the atom on the other side, opposite side, and lead to generation. Because the size of such defects is about several millimeters, it by many order more than the wavelength of X radiation, about several angstrom. So such process is coherent. It lead to formation of effect coherent or directed X-ray radiation. Sorry. Also, we have observed such experiment on this figure. We have the same. We have the same photoplate and situated in the direct position. Atomically pure surface, two sources of source of cavitation and opposite case. In this case, we have signal on the photoplate. In this case, signal is absent. It's because the connected that on the surface that was by paint, the process of excitation of acoustic wave is impossible. Also, this figure shows the additional experiments with closed cavitation chamber. It is a water stream. Inside the process cavitation in this chamber, it is motion water, and it is the external surface. And after we have investigation, X-ray radiation on near the surface. We have used created some combined optical rentgen and cavitate and shocking wave system combination, two kind of wave, X-ray radiation and shocking wave radiation. And we have created metal lens, and we have observed the focusing and defocusing action of such systems. It also illustration of such phenomena, focusing and defocusing system. The process of generation is related to land, for example. Process of generation of shocking wave was observed in additional experiments, absolutely independent experiments, not related to land phenomena. It is an experiment in steel. Steel glass and lead anode and also piezoelectric detector. During process of electrolysis system, the process of very intensive generation of acoustic pulse, a very short pulse, take place, the result of experiment. And also, the possible method of generation of shock wave and X-ray and fast formation of numerous microcracks at loading, interaction of hydrogen or deuterium with metal-matic during electrolysis gas exchange. For example, this is a blow discharge of electrolysis, beam of the ions inside the material cathode, and also it is a process of state of material because explosion of the cracks, and any fast explosive cracks of one cracks lead to generation of acoustic wave. This acoustic wave leads to accelerated explosion of additional cracks in a generation of a very intensive X-ray wave. In fact, such phenomena very like to the laser process. Initiation of shocking wave by one cracks lead to synchronized generation of main shocking wave. Also, conclusion, the generation of X-ray radiation outside the cavitation chamber is the result of the transformation of the cavitation shock wave in liquid to shock wave in the cavitation chamber wall and fast excitation of atom on the external surface of the chamber during reflection of its shock wave from the wall air body. Results experiment shows that the intensity acoustic wave connected with the cavitation processes are source intensive X-ray radiation. Frequency of radiation depends on substance of which shock wave extends and is transformed. Relative soft radiation with energy about 1 keV generated by surface of fast water jet in the area of cavitation. The more high energy up to 2 keV is generated by the surface of cylindrical steel rod with cavitation water jet. At the presence of heavy atoms on the rod surface, engine increases up to 5 keV. With a very high probability, this X-ray phenomenon observed at explosion of cavitation bubble that connected with the interaction cavitation induced shock wave with outer surface of working chamber of screen are similar to X-ray phenomena which take place during generation of similar shock wave at fast formation of numerous micro cracks at loading and interaction of hydrogen or deuterium during metal matrix during electrolysis and glow discharge. This result are published, first was published in 0.7 and last in the next month in the April number. Thank you for the attention.
Yeah, this is great data. 11 years ago, we did soundness experiments, SBSL, and we found that we were getting out 1 MeV gammas, or at least 1 MeV radiation, not necessarily gamma radiation. We always assumed this was an implication of the size of the bubble that was formed, the temperature that it went at. What you've just offered is an alternative means to produce those gamma rays on the inside surface of that bubble as the density shoots up, and you're producing what amounts to coherent shock waves.
Okay, my report is related on the only origin of soft X radiation outside of external surface of installation. Of course, it is follow from my analysis, and this result will be presented in my report on Sunday, that the explosion of cracks is really linked to the process of nuclear fusion, of course, and formation of X-ray of gamma radiation with high energy.
Yeah, but I'm not talking about fusion. What I'm saying is we're producing a bubble. We're reducing the volume by a billionfold. The temperature shoots up. We always assumed that the reason we were seeing gamma rays, light emissions, and gamma rays was because of high temperature. This offers an alternative because, in our case, the shell of the water, which actually at one point is ice,
According to all data of the result of detailed investigation of cavitation phenomena, the temperature inside during the process of cavitation is not temperature of nuclear level. Its maximum temperature is about maybe 100,000 degrees, only 10 eV, only 10 eV, no more. It is not nuclear scale, of course. During the process of cavitation, it is absolutely impossible. The stimulation of nuclear fusion, for example, not. Different process takes place at explosion of cracks, absolutely different regime. It is a macroscopic effect and lead to, from my view, lead to formation of so-named coherent correlated states, and I will present this result in one day.
I have a question. This is a species of shrimp called the pistol shrimp, and it actually creates sonoluminescent cavitation by snapping one of its claws and through a mechanism of doing that. I was wondering if there's any other mechanisms that you explored that could produce this sonoluminescent cavitation.
Sonoluminescence, it is a very weak phenomenon. The temperature during the process of sonoluminescence is very low. For so-named single bubble cavitation, it is the ideal case where only one bubble in all chamber. The temperature may be about 10 eV, or 100,000 degree temperature. It is very, very low temperature. So we have investigation of George regime of sonoluminescence, absolutely different. It's a very, very low intensity radiation that need special method for analysis. It is not related. It is absolutely different phenomena.
One of your earlier slides had a graph of a spectral shift occurring with a change in pressure, but the same material environment.
Yes.
When you're changing the material environment, I can see a spectral shift happening, but do you have an explanation for it?
We have observed changing of spectrum only for water stream. Water stream or machine oil, usually machine oil. It's a different phenomenon. And, of course, if we have increase of pressure, we have some shift, for example, two times, no more. But for more, for additional increase of pressure, the water stream not touch to the wall. And because this case is impossible, transition of the vibration energy to wall and possible to excitation of atom surface. And in this case, there are interesting processes. On the first stage, when X-ray radiation, we have observed only in the stage where the water stream touch to the internal surface of the wall. When we have the formation of directed stream, we have the generation of blue color lighting, but X-ray radiation is absent. It is different regime.
Does it depend on the dissolved air? Air dissolved in the water? Is air dissolved in the water which is going to compress it by pressure?
We have to investigate in detail. Just a moment, maybe. Okay. We have observed X radiation also only in this stage. In the stage of cavitation, where the water stream touch to the internal surface. In this case, X-ray radiation was absent. Because it's absent acoustic contact between surface of water and internal surface of this chamber. Only this area. Increased pressure in this from 30 up to maybe 40 atmosphere. The process of shift of X radiation take place, but in this regime, X radiation is absent. It was very specific regime, no more.
Do you